from the given, following next thing, and this thing is going to be more interesting because now we are talking about shortest job first, primitive. The logic is simple. The smallest, shortest job will be served. So let's go with it. How we will be talking about, be very, very careful. We're talking about now is the shortest job first, that too using primitive technique. Primitive technique is simple. If a higher priority or a better process exists, the current process will be stopped and next would be started. Just to work with it, let's understand this way. Till P1, or rather till bus cycle 1, nothing arrived. So arrival time from 1, the first entry P1 will take and immediately stopped at 2, because at this time we have P2. Let's try to understand on basis of shortest job first. This would be 1, this would be 2, this would be 3, and this would be 4. So on that basis, P1, which was executing, which is at priority 4, or rather at number 4, P2 can preempt it, that is to stop it. It arrives at 2, so P2 starts executing. P2 will be stopped, not by P3 because it has a higher number, but definitely by P4 because it has a lower. But when it will stop? It will stop at 4, that is after 2 bus cycle, because at 4 P4 enters. P4 takes over greatly. P4 only 3, only 3 bus times, but that would give a total to 7. Going further, once this is over, first thing is left over, that is P2, which was paused, will start. It will run for 2 bus cycle. After this, P2 is over, P4 is already over. Left is P3 and P1, P3, which is first executed, which would cost 5 bus cycles, making it 14. After which, leftover part of P1 is re-executed, which is 9. So totally coming out to be 23. Just to give burst timing of each, ran only for 1, ran for 2, ran for complete 3, ran for 2, ran for 5, and finally ran for. So now let's try to calculate wait period and other details for this. If we talk about total wait time, let's go with this way. For P1, P1 initially never waited, but then waited. So 0 plus, then it waited till it reached to 14. So 14, it waited, although it started at 1, so from 2 it waited. So in this case it is 14, but let's understand, P1 stopped at 2 and then started, so it should be 2 to 14. How would we say that? Well, simple, this would get minus 2 because it stopped at that point. Going for P2, P2 initially never waited, but then it started at 7, but it got stopped at 4. Similarly, when it comes to P3, P3 started at 9, but it arrived at 3, plus P4, which is the final entry, it never waited, so wait period is 0. So we have 12 plus this for P1, next 3, this is for P2, plus 6, which is for P3, and finally 0, which is for P4. So the total comes out to be 22. If we talk about average, 22 by 4, so it is 22 by 4, which is 5.5 in our case. Okay, similarly, if you talk about total turnaround time, That is, remember, we have clearly said, is the wait period plus the bus period. So wait period we have calculated, so let's go with it. 12 plus the burst of P1, which is 10. So next is 3 plus burst of 4 plus 6 plus burst of, which is 5, plus 0 plus burst of 3. This comes out to be 43. Average is by 5. So in our case it is 4. So that is 10.7. So this is shortest job, that too primitive. Be careful. Remember, when you deal with round robin, don't follow primitive. Majorly either priority or shortest path will only be primitive.